Hello students, welcome to my channel Learning History Made Easy. In today's video, I will be explaining about Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. Before going into the video, if anyone is seeing the channel for the first time or if you have not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe and share it with your friends. So without wasting time, let us get into the video. So as I have told you just before, today's video is about Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. So Sir M. Vishveshwaraya is considered as the architect and maker of modern Mysore. Sir M. Vishveshwaraya is called as the architect and maker of modern Mysore. Now we are going to see the reasons why he is referred to as the architect and maker of modern Mysore. So first let us see about his early life. He was born on 15th September 1861 at a place called as Muddenahalli. Sir M. Vishveshwaraya was born on 15th September 1861 at Muddenahalli. This Muddenahalli is in Chikbalapura district. His parents' name was Srinivasa Shastri and Venkata Lakshmamma were his parents. So he was born in Muddenahalli, Chikbalapura district, and parents were Srinivasa Shastri and Venkata Lakshmamma. Now his primary education he completed in Chikbalapura district only, and for his further studies he went to Bengaluru. After his primary education, he came to Bengaluru, and there he got BA degree from Central College. So he got BA degree from Central College. So Sir M. Vishveshwaraya is called as the architect and maker of modern Mysore. He was born on 15 September 1861 at Muddenahalli, Chikbalapura district. His parents were Srinivasa Shastri and Venkata Lakshmamma. He did his primary education in Chikbalapura and went to Bangalore for his further studies, and there he got his BA degree from Central College. Now after completing his BA degree from Central College, he moved to Pune for his engineering studies. So he did his engineering studies in Pune. Engineering studies also was completed. And after that, he got a job under Bombay government. So he served Bombay government from the time period 1884 to 1909. He worked under the Bombay government. Later, he was appointed as the chief engineer of Mysore. That was in the year 1909. So he completed his BA degree from Central College, Bangalore. Then he moved to Pune for his engineering studies. Later he served the Bombay government from 1884 to 1909, and he was appointed as the chief engineer of Mysore in 1909. After that, he was appointed as the Diwan of Mysore in the year 1912, and he was appointed as the Diwan of Mysore by Nalvadi Krishna Raja Vodayar appointed him as the Diwan of Mysore in the year 1912. So this is how Sir M. Vishveshwaraya became the Diwan of Mysore. So after completing his engineering studies from Pune, first he served under Bombay government until 1909. Then he became chief engineer of Mysore in 1909 and the Diwan of Mysore in 1912. So that was how Sir M. Vishveshwaraya became the Diwan of Mysore. Now let us see his reforms. The first reforms, administrative reforms. So under administrative reform, First thing he did was the number of members of legislative council was increased. The number of members of legislative council it was increased from 18 to 24. So it was first 18 and it was increased from 18 to 24. That was the first administrative reform done by Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. The local board and village panchayat regulation increased the number of elected members to districts. So there were local boards as well as village panchayat. The local boards and village panchayat regulation, both of these increased the number of elected members to districts and taluk boards. So it increased the number of elected members both to the district and taluk boards. This was also done during the time of Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. So first thing, the number of members of legislative council was increased from 18 to 24. The local boards and village panchayat regulation increased the number of elected members to district and taluk boards. The village reform committee was also established by Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. Village reform committees were established, and these village reform committees were established for the progress or the development of villages. Sir M. Vishveshwaraya was very particular about the development of villages, and for that purpose he established village reform committees. So these were some of the reforms done by Sir M. Vishveshwaraya regarding administration. After that, there was also a separate plan for the development of Malnad region. So he introduced separate plan, that is for the development of Malnad region. So that was also done by Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. So these were the administrative reforms introduced by Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. Let us just see the points. He was considered as the architect and maker of modern Mysore. He was born on 15 September 1861 at Muddanahalli in Chikbalapura district. His parents were Srinivasa Shastri and Venkata Lakshmamma. He completed his primary education at Chikbalapura. He went to Bengaluru for his further studies and got his BA degree from Central College. He moved to Pune for his engineering studies and he served Bombay government from 1884 to 1909. He was appointed as the chief engineer of Mysore in 1909. Later, in 1912, he was appointed as Diwan of Mysore by Nalvadi Krishnaraja Vodayar. During his Diwanship, Mysore witnessed all-round development. Now his administrative reforms, the number of members of legislative council was increased from 18 to 24. Local board and village panchayat regulation increased the number of elected members to the district and taluk boards. Village reform committees were established for the progress of villages. There was also a separate plan for the development of Malnad region. Now let us see the next reform done by Sir M. Vishveshwaraya, that is industrial development. Industrial development. Now the main slogan of Sir M. Vishveshwaraya regarding industries was industrialize or perish. So this shows the importance which he gave to the development of industries. This was a very famous slogan of Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. And during this time, he started a number of industries. Many industries were started by Sir M. Vishveshwaraya, that is iron works, that is in Bhadravati. This was one industry. Then sandal oil factory at Mysore. was started at Mysore. Then soap factory or the metal factory, soap factory, all were started in Bangalore. So like this, many industries were started by Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. Iron works at Bhadravati, sand oil factory at Mysore, metal factory, soap factory at Bangalore, central industrial workshop, so many industries were started. And for the support for trade and commerce, he started the Mysore Chamber of Commerce and Industry. Mysore Chamber of Commerce and Industry. This was started by Sir M. Vishveshwaraya to support trade and commerce. This was started in Bangalore, and this was started for the purpose of supporting traders and supporting trade and commerce. So his famous slogan was industrialize or perish. During this time, he started a number of industries like iron work at Bhadravati, sandal oil factory at Mysore, metal factory and soap factory at Bangalore, etc. He started the Mysore Chamber of Commerce and Industry, and this was established at Bangalore to support trade and commerce. After that, during this period, he gave importance not only to large scale industries, he gave importance to small scale industries also. Other than large scale industries, he gave importance to small scale industries. If you see small scale industries, there were many cottage industries which developed during his time. Cottage industries such as weaving, then pottery work, woodwork, agarbatti industry, all these small scale industries also developed during the time of Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. For the support of all these industries and traders, Mysore Bank was founded in the year 1913 for the promotion of industries and commerce. For the financial support, Mysore Bank was started in 1913. So other than large scale industries, small scale industries also were given importance, and that also developed. Cottage industries such as weaving, pottery, woodwork, agarbatti work, etc. flourished. The Mysore Bank was started in 1913 for the promotion of industries and commerce. That was about industrial development. Now the next reform of Sir M. Vishveshwaraya is educational reform. Now in the field of education, what all changes were brought? He believed that progress of a country, any country's progress of a country mainly depended on the education of its people. If the people are educated, the country will develop. Education of people. So Sir M. Vishveshwaraya believed that progress of a country depends on the education of its people, and for that purpose he introduced compulsory primary education was introduced by Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. And for giving encouragement, he introduced scholarship programs for specially socially and economically backward classes. Economically and socially backward classes were supported by giving them scholarships. So scholarships were introduced to encourage socially and economically backward classes. He also encouraged female education as well as technical education. Both these were encouraged by Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. Female education as well as technical education were given importance. So he believed that progress of a country mainly depends on the education of its people. He introduced compulsory primary education. Scholarships were introduced to encourage socially and economically backward classes. Female education and technical education was given much importance during his period. Now He started the engineering college at Bangalore. So the main institution started by Sir M. Visveswaraya, the first one was the engineering college, which was started in Bangalore. And then he also, as I told, he encouraged technical education. For that purpose, he started the Chamarajendra Technical Institute. Technical Institute was started. This was started at Mysore. So Engineering College at Bangalore and Chamarajendra Technical Institute at Mysore was started. And again, he also established an agricultural school. This was agricultural school was established at Hebbal in Bangalore. It was established at Hebbal. And the most important achievement of Sir M. Visveswaraya was the establishment of the Mysore University. This was in 1916. This was his greatest achievement regarding the educational reform. So the main institutions established by him, the engineering college was started at Bangalore, Chamarajendra Technical Institute at Mysore, agricultural school was established at Hebbal, and the establishment of Mysore University was his greatest achievement. And he also established the Kannada Sahitya Parishad. Kannada Sahitya Parishad, and Kannada Sahitya Parishad was established in the year 1915. So these were the reforms of Sir M. Visveswaraya in the field of education. So just let us go through the points once more. Industrial development, industrialize or perish, was a famous slogan of Sir M. Visveswaraya. During his time, a number of industries started, like the iron works in Bhadravati, sandal oil factory at Mysore, soap factory, central industrial workshop, metal factory at Bangalore, etc. Mysore Chamber of Commerce and Industry was established at Bangalore to support trade and commerce. During his period, small scale industries also developed. Cottage industries such as weaving, pottery, woodwork, leather goods, agarbatti industries also flourished. The Mysore Bank was founded in 1913 for the promotion of industries and commerce. Now regarding educational reforms, he believed that the progress of a country mainly depends on the education of its people. He introduced compulsory primary education. Scholarships were introduced to encourage education among the socially and economically backward classes. Female education and technical education was given importance. The engineering college at Bangalore and the Chamarajendra Technical Institute at Mysore was started. He also established an agricultural school at Hebbal in Bangalore. The establishment of Mysore University in 1916 was his greatest achievement. And the Kannada Sahitya Parishad was established in 1915. Now, let us move on to some other achievements of Sir M. Visveswaraya. So, we will see some more achievements, other achievements. So here, the first important achievement was the construction of the Krishnaraja Sagara Dam. Krishnaraja Sagara Dam was one of the main achievements, that is KRS Dam, was one of the greatest achievements of Sir M. Visveswaraya. And in 1913, a railway line was laid between Mysore and Arasikere. Mysore-Arasikere railway line, and one more railway line was laid between Bowringpete-Kolar railway line. These two railway lines were laid in 1913 was also considered to be the achievement of Sir M. Visveswaraya. So the construction of Krishnaraja Sagara Dam was his greatest achievement. In 1913, the Mysore-Arasikere railway line and Bowringpete-Kolar railway lines were laid. Now, there were also some relief works done by Sir M. Visveswaraya. The First World War broke out during the diwanship of Sir M. Visveshwaraya. So, one of the important world event happened during this time, that was First World War. And when First World War happened, there was severe shortage of food. Food shortage was a big issue. And for this purpose, he started fair price shops. So, fair price shops were started, and these fair price shops, in that selling prices were fixed. Selling prices were fixed. So there was food shortage during the time of First World War, and he opened up fair price shops, and in these fair price shops the selling prices were fixed. And Sir M. Visveshwaraya resigned his post in 1918. So he resigned from his post in 1918. So after he resigned his post in 1918, he continued his works, he continued his relief works and developmental activities. Because of all his activities, he was conferred the title Sir. Visveshwaraya was conferred the title Sir, and this was done by the British government. So the British government conferred him the title Sir for his efficiency and dedicated service. So as I told, he continued to take part in the developmental activities even after resignation, and he was given the Bharat Ratna Award. Bharat Ratna Award was conferred to him by the government of India. So the British government gave him the title Sir, and the government of India conferred the Bharat Ratna Award in 1955. And Sir M. Visveshwaraya was the first Kannadiga to receive this award. The first Kannadiga to receive this Bharat Ratna Award. Sir M. Visveshwaraya died in 1962. And he wrote a number of important books. Some of his important books, the first important book is A Vision of Prosperous Mysore. A Vision of Prosperous Mysore. Another important book is Reconstructing India. Reconstructing India was another important book. Rapid Development of Industries. Rapid Development of Industries, etc. There were many important books, and one of his autobiography, Memoirs of My Working Life, is his autobiography. So these were the important books of Sir M. Visveshwaraya. So Sir M. Visveshwaraya was given the title Sir by the British government for his efficiency and dedicated service. He continued to take active part in the developmental activities of the state even after resignation. The government of India conferred him the Bharat Ratna Award in 1955. He was the first Kannadiga to get this award. He died in 1962. His main books are A Vision of Prosperous Mysore, Reconstructing India, Rapid Development of Industries, Planned Economy for India, and his autobiography is Memoirs of My Working Life. This is his autobiography. So all these are the reason why Sir M. Visveshwaraya is called as the architect and maker of modern Mysore. So let us see the final points which we have studied. Construction of the Krishnarajasagara Dam was his greatest achievement. In 1913, the Mysore-Arasikere and Bauringpete-Kola railway lines were laid. In relief work, the First World War broke out during the diwanship of Sir M. Visveshwaraya. There was a severe shortage of food, and he took up relief work by opening fair price shops, stopping exports of food grains, and also by fixing the selling prices. He resigned in 1918. He was conferred the title Sir by the British government for his efficiency and dedicated service. He continued to take active part in the developmental activities of the state even after his resignation. The government of India conferred the Bharat Ratna Award in 1955. He was the first Kannadiga to get this award. He died in 1962. His main books were A Vision of Prosperous Mysore, Reconstructing India, Rapid Development of Industries, Planned Economy for India, and Memoirs of My Working Life is his autobiography. Now, let us see some important questions. Where was Vishveshwaraya born? Muddenahalli in Chikbalapura district. In which year was the Mysore University established? 1916. Who founded the Kannada Sahitya Parishad? Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. Name the bank established by Vishveshwaraya? Mysore Bank. What was the famous slogan of Vishveshwaraya regarding industrial development? Industrialize or perish. Who was the first Kannadiga who secured Bharat Ratna Award? Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. Who built the Krishnarajasagara Dam? Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. Name the parents of Vishveshwaraya, Srinivasa Shastri and Venkata Lakshmamma. Mention any two books written by Vishveshwaraya, A Vision of Prosperous Mysore, Reconstructing India, Rapid Development of Industries, any two books names you can write. And the 10th one, Sir M. Vishveshwaraya is called the maker of modern Mysore, explain. The answer is explained in the video. All the points included in the video has to be written for this answer. So I hope you have understood all the points very clearly. This question is a very important question regarding your final exams, and this question usually comes as a 10 mark essay question. So if you have any doubts regarding this topic or any other topic, you can ask in the comment section. So please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Your likes, shares and comments will be of a great encouragement for me to make more and more videos. So I hope to see you all soon in the next video. Thank you for watching.